So go and tell us how you got started with table tennis.
So I actually, my professional career was actually in minor league hockey. And the sport of ping pong, and we called it, and we had a ping pong table in our locker room, and almost every professional sports team, I'd say probably 75 to 80% of special professional sports teams, had ping pong tables in their locker room. And one day I was down in our locker room, it was in Reading, Pennsylvania, and there was a ping pong table there, and I played when I was a little kid, and I loved it when I was a little kid, and my parents couldn't get me out of the game room. And there was a ping pong table, so I just started playing and playing and playing and playing. And I got to the point in the locker room where I was beating people who were professional athletes, and I thought I was really good. And of course, at the time, I held the paddle wrong. And we played to 21, and we served right out of our hand, and we did everything wrong. So my wife found out that all of the hours that I told her I was at work, I was actually downstairs playing ping pong in the locker room. And her friend of hers belonged to a club in Reading. And she said, you know, you love it so much, you should go try at the club. So I went to the club, and I walked in with my $10 Dick's Sporting Goods paddle, and somebody said, are you any good? And I said, I think I'm pretty good. And they said, are you a 2000? Of course, I didn't know what a 2000 meant at that point. And of course, I said, yeah, I'm a 2000. That sounds good. You know, I'm a 2000, whatever that means. I had no idea. That night, I lost to an 85-year-old guy, 3-0. And I decided that night that ping pong was going to be my sport. And I've grown to love it.
Great. I mean, that's an amazing start to a career where now today you're a CEO of USATT.